Use the spatula to force it off.
10 seconds remaining.
Oh, it's going, it's going.
It's going.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. A stunning, delicious cheesecake.
A cheesecake, and my heart sinks. Not excited.
I'm ecstatic. I love cheesecake. I'm very happy.
A rich, creamy filling. A crisp, sweet crust. Perfect balance of texture and flavor. One ingredient overused, and the beautiful balance will be destroyed.
I'm not a baker. I've made it once before, once, and it didn't really turn out. So I'm freaking out.
To be perfectly honest, I'm not a baker and I've never cooked a cheesecake, but I've been on a pressure test before and I've battled my way out of it. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do today.
To make this cheesecake in 90 minutes, that's a lot of pressure. This is a tough test for them. Some of the pitfalls would be obviously overbaking, underbaking.
Too much air wouldn't be good. Not enough air would not be good either, right? You want that nice, creamy center, almost dense.
And not too high in the oven and not too low, right in the center rack.
There is no way that this cheesecake is sending me home today. Absolutely not.
You have 5 minutes before you should have the cheesecakes in the oven baking.
Holy it's right, guys.
Kayla has just pulled out some chocolate. So my concern would be it's starting to get a little too sweet.
Yeah.
Too heavy.
Everyone else is just gonna do their standard cheesecake. And I really think that taking this risk is either gonna make me or break me.
It's good.
Now, I just noticed Danielle was passing her cheesecake mixture through a fine chinois.
That's smart. Get rid of the little connecting tissue with the egg.
Right.
It's very smart.
We're at the 15-minute mark. You need to have those cheesecakes in the oven now.
Straight in or on a pan?
On a sheet pan.
No, that extra metal is conducive.
No, put it on the sheet pan.
That cheesecake's worth $100,000.
You have that much extra metal to heat up. Are you kidding me? Thank you, Josh.
Kayla, come on. Put it in the oven, Kayla.
And now we need to see what they do with garnishes.
So it's neck and neck.
Listen, I'm making a passion fruit topping. It's gonna be unbelievable.
You know what I'm interested in is Josh's approach. He has mangoes, he has passion fruit. I think it's gonna be interesting what he does. But you know who I'm worried about? Dale. I think Dale's toppings are gonna look messy. He's got all these different purees. It's gonna look like a mistake.
Rum or bourbon?
Rum.
Stay tropical, man.
Heads up.
So fancy, Josh.
Listen.
Well, he seems to be very relaxed. He's talking to Calorie. He's talking to everyone.
Yeah. Why not cook with fire?
Woo! Off the flame.
Chef.
Josh.
How are you?
I'm great. More importantly, how are you?
I'm doing pretty well, actually. I got my passion fruit going for my topping. It smells amazing. Kind of been wafting it towards the gallery. I think they appreciate that. So I'm feeling pretty good with this right now.
Well, good luck.
Appreciate that, Chef.
Again, I love that limoncello.
Thank you. Right?
The moment I take my cake out, my heart sinks. My whole entire cheesecake has fallen.
Two minutes left. Finishing touches, tidying up, getting ready to present.
I go to pull the spring form, and sure enough, it is stuck to that bad boy.
45 seconds remaining. You need to hustle.
I gotta get my cake on this plate, but it's stuck. I mean, the thing is basically frozen to the cake pan.
Oh, damn it, Josh.
Use the spatula to force it out.
10 seconds remaining.
Oh, it's going.
It's going.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands up.
Oh, God, that was crazy.
I'm really worried. I've got a pit in my stomach.
Josh's looks the messiest, probably.
Half of his cake is still on his plate.
I think my cake's a disaster, but Kayla's cake looked like a chocolate cake with a little bit of cheese in it.
My cake definitely stands out. That could either be great for me or it could be really, really bad.
I'm actually really happy. It's risen and there's no cracks.
They're all in trouble.
I don't know what to think as I'm walking up. I know my cake tastes good. I know it may not look good.
Are you happy with the way your cheesecake turned out?
I'm very disappointed. I make cheesecake all the time. It's pretty much my favorite dessert.
It's a generous portion of topping to crust. Very smooth, very creamy. The cream cheese is coming through very nicely. And the contrast of that crust, it eats very well, but doesn't present as well.
I thought you'd made this hundreds of times.
I have, chef.
You know, I expected so much more from you based on how confident you were going into this competition. Fanned out strawberries are very typical. Everything I've seen from you so far is creative.
Danielle, please bring your cheesecake up here.
It's a limoncello key lime cheesecake.
Oh, looks nice. But taste also counts. Crust is crispy. I get the Philadelphia cream cheese, which I like.
Wow. What do you think of that profile?
It actually looks quite nice.
Doesn't get much better.
Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you.
It's actually beyond very good.
Thank you very much, chef.
Kayla, please bring up your cheesecake.
I'm super stressed out because it doesn't look as pretty as I thought it did, and something as small as that could literally send me home.
Wow. Wow. You did a nice marbling effect. You missed a little bit of crust, though.
Yes, chef.
But I give you marks for definitely standing out from everyone else. The only I'm concerned about here is that you didn't really honor the main ingredient, which is cheese.
I just wanted to do something a little bit different.
Well, if different was your goal, you achieved that.
In a bad way?
In a good way.
Thank you, chef.
I think my cake looks the worst, hands down.
Josh, would you please bring a cheesecake up?
I'm just hoping that the flavors are going to speak for themselves. The judges are going to see that I was trying to be innovative, creative, and take risks.
Look, obviously from its immediate presentation, it's disappointing. The cracks, the way it's slumped, damaged edge. But it holds well. Very good. Have you made cheesecake before?
No, I have not.
That passion fruit, it's quite magical.
Thank you, chef.
But it still looks disastrous.
I agree. The plating wasn't there, but I wanted to be innovative and use flavors that hadn't been done before, and I'm hoping you're going to see that and taste that with my cake today.
I can understand that you're hoping that.
You think that's innovative?
It's inspired by the art we saw yesterday. It's a little postmodern, you know? Aside from that, the flavors are where the innovation
is. The flavors. What was it? Tropical?
Tropical. Absolutely. I think all of my food has been innovative, creative, and delicious. I certainly think this is the same. I think the plating just got away from me in the last minute there.
The only thing tropical about this, it's a typhoon hit it.
The only thing that can save you right now is how this thing tastes.